Chieftain said, "Whence art thou come?" The prostrate youth replied, "From Israel's camp, once dreaded Israel's pride." "How," says the chieftain, "did the battle go?" Chance to stray all of the Gilmore's ever devious way. Behold, Saul leaned on his oft-lifted spear, chariots and horsemen thundering on his rear. A king looks back, and seeing me, he cries, "Come forward, youth!" On swiftest feet I rise. Arrived, says Saul, "Who art thou? Use no fraud." I answer, "An Amalekite, my lord." The king then sighed, as though his heart were broke. Tears parted his eyes, and thus he faintly spoke.
Swore it nevermore will. with thunder, David rends his clothes and calls for vengeance on insulting foes.
Whence art thou? He goes on, I'm an Amalekite, a stranger son. Ah, cries the chieftain, wretch, what hast thou done? Ah, wretch, what hast thou done?
Conscience hush the skins when our vengeance to destroy God's anointed chief of kings, soul who for the nation's joy, who for the nation's joy. Now, conscience hushed her steeds, when now then there to destroy God's anointed chief of kings. So, whose full the nation's joy, a nation's joy. How could conscience hush her steeds, when thou tempest, thou tempest to destroy God's anointed chief of kings, so to form the nation's joy, the nation's joy. How could conscience hush her steeds, when thou tempest, thou tempest to destroy God's anointed chief of kings, so to form the nation's joy. Could conscience hush her steeds, when thou tempest to destroy God's anointed chief of kings, so to form the nation's
said, advance, unsheath thy sword. The man obeyed. Plunge, plunge it deep, cries David. In his side he smote the regicide. He fell, he died. The chieftain then, thy blood be on thy head, for thou a monarch's sacred blood hast shed, as thine own lips now testified to plain, saying, the Lord's anointed I have slain. Breathe his sigh.
Philistine daughters lift their voice. The daughters of the uncircumcised rejoice.
Nor queen.
To thy. blessed with one, deadened by the bleeding smart, the stream of life runs low. The stream of life runs low. Music's healing voice applied, heals away his pain, gently swells the spirit's tide, and briskly springs again.
Thank you. salons, the bravest she wounds, the bravest she wounds. When music elate, no fearing to die, to doubtful's the fate, to battle they fly, they fly. To doubtful's the fate, to battle they fly. In war's fierce alarms, the bravest she wounds, the bravest she wounds. By music elate, no fearing to die, no doubtful's the fate, to battle they fly. To battle they fly. Fearing to die, no doubtful set fate, to battle they fly. No doubtful set fate, to battle they fly. Trumpet loudly calls to arms, all terror falls, all terror falls. Rouse up the very cowards most, their frightened courage lost, the very cowards most. Rouse up the very cowards most, their fighting courage lost. In war's fierce alarms, the bravest she warms, the bravest she warms. When music elate, no fearing to die, to doubtful's the fate, to battle they fly, they fly. To doubtful's the fate, to battle they fly. War's fierce alarms, the bravest she wounds. By music elate, no fearing to die, the doubtful's the fate, to battle they fly. To battle they fly. No feeling to buy, no doubtful set pay, to battle they fly. No doubtful their fate, to battle they fly. Melody confined to soothe the breasts of humankind. Her piercing sounds can quickly wing their flight to the Almighty King. Thank you.
skilled be none in God, nor spread in scoffing Ascalon, lest the Philistine daughters lift their voice, the daughters of the uncircumcised rejoice.